için. Ichenandam, hello, welcome. You're watching Causing Claire. Thank you so much for being here and watching. Today's video is going to be on steps you can take and what you need to do in order to be able to cause your reality so that you can go see Swamiji, my guru, Paramahamsa Nityananda. He offers amazing 21-day yoga and meditation retreats. Many of us work towards attending these programs, and a lot of times there is many things that come up in our path in order to be able to go. We perceive them as obstacles. For some, they need the money to attend the program. For others, it's their family, relationships, time off work. All sorts of things can come up when you are working towards manifesting to attend to see Swamiji for one of his programs. So in this space for all of you, I'm going to start with the Guru Vandanam, which is our cosmic prayer. So if you'll just close your eyes. Nityanandam paramasukatam kevalam yanamurtyam dvandvatitam gaganasadrisyam tatvamasyadilakshyam ekam nityam vimalamachalam sarvadi sakshibhutam bhavatitam trigunarahitam sadgurum tam namami. That always invokes Swamiji's energy and presence to do the Guru Vandanam. So in this space, let's now chat about getting to, we'll call it inner awakening. Right now, there's a program called Paramahashivoham. The names change frequently, but let's talk about getting to go see Swamiji. So number one thing that it takes in order to be able to manifest this program as your reality is your decision. Really, actually, I could say that that's the only thing that's required, is your strong intention and decision, desire to want to go. Oftentimes we're homing and hoeing and don't know if I want to go or not. If you have the clear, strong decision that this is of the utmost importance for your life, that this is the solution, that this is the path for you, then it has to be a strong decision in your space to want to attend, to want to go. Okay, so you always have to pull yourself back to this just being a decision, just clearly deciding and declaring in your space that, yes, I want to go see Swamiji. I want to attend this program, and I'm going to do whatever it takes to get there. I know this might seem dramatic, but it really is a decision in space that has to be life or death for you. Okay, if I were to give you a saying that says, hey, you have 24 hours to live. You have to manifest the money. You have to manifest your family's permission. You have to manifest the time off work. Think of the lengths that you would go to in order to make that happen so that you could live. It's the same intensity and decision towards life that's required in order to manifest this program. So if you're not there yet, that's okay. This isn't about right or wrong, all right? And there's no guilt involved in this. But just know that that's the decision space you have to be in order to make this happen. Okay, so that's the first and foremost thing, all right? Just do that and the program will happen. The next thing that you need to do in order to make this reality happen is action. You have to take action. You cannot just say with that strong decision that, yes, I want to go see Swamiji, I want to attend this program, and then not take any action. You can't just sit around doing nothing and expect it to happen. Every single day when you get up in the morning, first priority on your mind, how am I going to make this happen? What do I need to do? Okay, and a lot of times that space will come with needing to manifest the money, right? So just know that what can you dig up, wherever you can find the money, whatever you can do to come up with it, do that and Swamiji will do the rest. But you have to do something on your part. You have to take some action, okay? And it's a large amount of money that takes to go to one of these programs, right? No doubt, but there's a reason for that, okay? And it is all about intensity and what you are willing to put towards your life, towards making this shift happen, because it's not easy. You go through everything and anything in this program in order to clear out your space, to be able to have a blank slate, to create the life you want, to manifest the life you want. And that takes some house cleaning, okay? So the house has to be cleaned, the inner house space has to be cleaned top to bottom. And that is sometimes a tumultuous process. A lot of things will come up. You have to dig up everything that has not wanted to be faced. You have to do the deep clean in order to have this shift happen in you. So just know that action has to be taken every single day towards where you're going to find the money, what you're going to do, and how much does this mean to me? It has to be your number one priority, okay? Same with needing to get your family's permission, your work's permission. You have to hold this space and desire and intensity that this is what you want and taking action towards it, okay? So whether that is being the space of listening for your family, right? Listen to what they have to say and all the objections and obstacles that they put in your way. Because whatever your family's saying outside of you, it's really just what you're saying inside of you. And you may just not be aware of it. So your deep listening is an action you can take towards that, okay? Now, with work, for example, I personally, and you all get to make personal choices, I personally was very clear a few years back that if work would not allow me the time to go, then I was going to find a new job, okay? That's the intensity of my action. That's not something that you have to choose, but it's a choice that I made because that's how badly I wanted to go and that was my space. Happy news was that work came around and I was able to go and get the time. But I was very clear in my space and in my life that this is what I wanted and this is what needed to happen for me. So whatever I needed to do, I was going to do it. Through all of this, no matter whether it's money or family or time, work, whatever, hold that strong decision and then give the rest over to Swamiji. What that means is always remember him when you are feeling low or when you're feeling powerless in any way that you're not sure if this is going to happen. Just remember Swamiji. Close your eyes and visualize him, especially in your third eye, and connect with him and ask him for help. And I'm telling you, the help will be given because Swamiji wants you there. He wants to see you and he wants to have you in his home of Adi Kailash. Okay, so anytime any powerless comes up, any powerlessness, visualize Swamiji and just know that he's here to support you to make it happen. You only have to do so minor little things in order for him to be able to do the rest, okay? But you have to open up your space to allow him to rush in and come do it. Okay, so just as quick recap for this video so that you can watch it again and again and not take up too much of your time. Number one, strong decision. Make the strong, firm decision that this is what you want to do, life or death, this is your priority. Okay? Number two, take action. Every single day, do an action towards getting there, whether that be looking for the money somewhere, whether that be having a conversation with a family member, giving your listening, watching a satsang, watching a YouTube video, reaching out to the many members of us that help people get to see Swamiji, whether that's having an uncomfortable conversation with your worker boss to ask for the time. Please, out of anything else, fill out an intention form online. Go to innerawakening.org. There's always intention forms for programs that you can fill out, and that just lets Swamiji know, he gets to see all of them, that you want to go. Also, something that really, really helps, put a deposit down. If you can put a deposit down as well, that really starts to move the energy and start to shift things forward. That shows your commitment, okay? And then always bring Swamiji into your space. Every single time you feel powerless or you feel like this can't happen, visualize Swamiji, ask him for help, and just know that it will be given. Just know that you have to take just small steps and he will do the rest for you. And that there are thousands of us that don't have a whole bunch of money just sitting in the bank waiting for this to happen, okay? It's not the super rich that are just able to go see Swamiji. I did not start out super rich, although I ended up coming out very wealthy after programs. But the first one, no, I didn't have the money sitting there, okay? So just know that just like you, everybody else is in the same boat and we make it happen. Swamiji makes it happen. You just have to have that strong.
नित्यानन्देश्वर परमशिवसमारम्भाम् नित्यानन्देश्वरि पराशक्तिमध्यमाम् अस्मदाचार्यपर्यन्ताम् वन्दे गुरुपरम्पराम्। I welcome you all with my love and respect. I am ready with all the beautiful gifts from Kailasa to share with you all. First thing I want to tell you, I am committed to make myself available to all of you and make all the best things from the Kailasa to make it available as user friendly day-to-day practical usable gifts. All the best things from the Kailasa will be made available to whole humanity, best user-friendly way, whether it is the science of power manifestation or the mandalas, extraordinary planets. Please understand, I am not using the word plants. Plants is separate. Planets. Graha mandalas, which creates an energy field when it is placed in your home or office, they are called planets, the energy planets, the graha mandalas. This is the next gift from Kailasa. I have brought it for all of you. Understand all this, everything. I am committed to make it as user friendly, available to all of you. From today, will be continuously available to all of you. Through morning and evening satsangs, morning satsang will be in English, evening satsang will be in Tamil, and the Kailasa Senate meetings, Kailasa Congress meetings, Kailasa Lok Sabha meetings and Kailasa Rajya Sabha meetings. Kailasa will have 4 parliamentary bodies: Senate, Congress, Lok Sabha and Rajya Sabha. So those Kailasa parliamentary meetings also I'll be available, and every day I'll be accepting the Pada Puja and doing Dial the Avatar calls and all the other sevas I'll be accepting personally. So I'll be available to all of you. I'm committed to all of you and I'll be available to all of you. That's the first assurance I wanted to give for all my devotees, disciples, sannyasis, yogis, yoginis, especially my favorite Gurukul Balasans, my kids. I know it was very difficult 1 year for all of you, me not being available continuously, maybe last 2 years. So, today ends all those sufferings and all those periods. From today, I'll be continuously available. How I was available in 2003, 2004, 2005, in those years. Because now, the internet facilities are available. I'll be available more than 2004, 5. Maybe I will be available for all of you 18 hours a day. And the remaining 6 hours, I'll be available for the Kailasa parliamentary meetings. Kailasa Senate, Kailasa Congress and Kailasa Rajya Sabha and Kailasa Lok Sabha meetings. All the sciences, power manifestation, healing, raising the quality of your existence, consciousness, everything Paramashiva has gifted, he has downloaded into this system and it is manifesting for all of you as a gift to humanity. Understand, all my disciples, all of you will realize the waiting was worth. I know I have made you all wait for at least last 2 years. You will realize now the waiting was worth because of the quality of the gifts downloaded into this system through this period, this time of spiritual seclusion. The amazing gifts Paramashiva has downloaded into this system. I am overflowing in oneness, samadhi, love, gratitude, awareness, integrity with Paramashiva. Understand all the words I uttered. Awareness, integrity, love, faith, belief, oneness. All these are actually one and the same when you connect with Paramashiva. I tell you, faith in Paramashiva or being aware of your existence, belief in Paramashiva or being integrated to Paramashiva or oneness with Paramashiva, all these are same. I'm overflowing with that space and will ensure all of you who declare your integrity to me also experience that same space. The first thing I wanted to share with you, nothing is needed from your side other than declaring simple integrity. Just simple integrity and listen to these satsangs, that is enough. This system is now fully ripe with extreme compassion and life positive attitude. Understand? when I declared my simple integrity to my Guru. Arunagiri Yogeshwara, all I know is what he loves, I will love. What he hates, I will hate. What he wants, I will want. What he does not want, I will not want. That's it. That's what I call simple integrity. You don't even need to struggle because I am going to give you the most powerful logic in which Paramashiva functions. Understand? Please, all of you, understand this one point. We always think we are too smart. Just by coming to conclusion, we can execute the conclusion. Whenever I try to speak elaborately about vegetarian lifestyle or compassion, people try to intervene and say, Swamiji, what do you want to say? You mean I should be vegetarian? I should drop non-veg? That's all, na? Okay. But whoever talks like that, I've always seen they fail when they start executing. Understand? Listen very carefully. If you try to jump to conclusion without loading yourself with enough powerful cognitions, your conclusions will not be powerful enough to break your patterns. So when you struggle, when your conclusions are not powerful enough to break your patterns, when you struggle, when your conclusions become powerless, you enter into frustration and your anger turns towards Guru and the whole system, science. Understand, whenever you are not able to make your conclusions into reality, gather more knowledge, more powerful cognitions. The higher logic with which the powerful cognitions can be realized in your system, can become reality in your system, gather them. Understand? Now, I am loaded with powerful cognitions. All you need is a simple declaration of your integrity to me. That's it. Nothing else. Just simple integrity. Nothing else. And listen. These powerful cognitions, when they fill you more and more, they will make your conclusions powerful enough to break the patterns. Jumping to conclusions without gathering enough powerful cognitions is the reason you fail to execute your conclusions. You fail to manifest your conclusions as reality in your life. Many times I have seen, whether I am talking about celibacy, or I am talking about vegetarianism, or I am talking about breaking the tiredness, breaking the boredom, breaking the laziness, or breaking the delusion, breaking the confusion, breaking the violence, breaking the anger, breaking the lying pattern. Whatever I am talking about, if you decide, this is the conclusion, if you jump to conclusion without loading yourself with enough powerful cognitions, your conclusions will not be powerful enough to break your patterns. And when your conclusions are not able to break your patterns, you get into frustration and powerlessness, and your anger turns towards the system and the Guru and the Sangha. You start losing trust on Guru, Linga and Sangha. understand? Now I am loaded with enough powerful cognitions. Just sit with simple integrity. I will load you with this powerful cognition. Simply the conclusions will break your patterns and become reality. Some of the fundamental truths about existence. Your existence, understand? Some of the fundamental truths about your existence, if you internalize, the many conclusions which you come to, I will not even give those conclusions. You yourself will arrive to those conclusions. When you yourself arrive to those conclusions, you will simply execute it. So listen to this understandings, jnana pada, knowledge. When it is internalized, lifestyle, devotion, yoga, all the three automatically manifest spontaneously and simultaneously. When jnana pada is internalized properly from the right guru, charya pada lifestyle, kriya pada devotion, yoga pada the yogic manifestation, all that happens simultaneously and spontaneously. That is the power of jnana pada, the right powerful cognitions, understandings. You have four components in you. In your life as reality. One, the matter. Pure matter. Like this floor, ground, or this yoga danda, this mic, physical matters, this throne, simhasana. That is one component. Second, how this physical matter is experienced by you. Mana, mind, understand? Physical matter is not experienced as same by everyone. It varies from person to person. For example, this yoga danda, for me, this is the power storehouse. Whatever powers I have brought from Kailasa, I store it in this, in the form of Kundalini, and release it when I initiate people. For somebody, it may be beautiful silver artwork. For somebody, it is a snake. For somebody, it is just a piece of art. Some may think, how can I get that? Some may think, if I get it, I will worship it. Some may think, if I get it, I will sell it and drink. Some may think, oh, it is too valuable. It should be only with Swamiji and should be used only to initiate all of us. Some may think, can I just touch it and do namaskar, receive the powers? So, you may perceive and experience the same yoga danda in a different way. So your mana, which perceives the matter, is the second component of you. Third, buddhi, your intelligence, which bridges your matter and mana to consciousness. I should say, how your consciousness perceives the matter and mana is buddhi, intelligence. Understand? I can use various words, but now I am defining this four parts: matter, mind, which experiences matter, intelligence, buddhi. Actually, buddhi is the decision maker. Buddhi is the executive authority of your life. Consciousness is only a constitutional authority. Buddhi is the executive authority in your existence. It is through buddhi, consciousness receives or sends information. Buddhi receives and passes to consciousness, and buddhi receives from consciousness and sends it to matter and mind. Understand these four components of reality. Listen. All these four works in the same frequency throughout the planet Earth. For example, if you are intelligent in US, you will be same intelligent if you go to China or India. If you are intelligent in India, you will have the same intelligence whether you go to Australia or Paris. The relationship between the matter, mass, buddhi and intelligence and consciousness will be same throughout the planet Earth. Understand carefully. How in planet Earth we have time zones, like Indian Standard Time, Pacific Time, East Coast separate time and West Coast separate time, various time zones planet Earth has, but all these time zones are horizontal, means same space. In all these time zones, the matter, the way you perceive the matter, mind and your intelligence, decision making authority and your consciousness functions in the same equation. See, the equation between these four does not change whether you are in India or America or Australia, East Coast or West Coast or Central Time Zone or the any time zone of the planet Earth. The equation between these four does not alter in you. Listen, I'll repeat. Understanding this truth will help you to come to many powerful cognition conclusions. And those powerful cognitive conclusions will enlighten you. They will make you manifest many powerful cognitions and make you manifest powers. Understand? I'll repeat. Matter, then mind. How you experience matter. For example, if somebody slaps you, the pain of the slapping disappears in few minutes, but the suffering that he slapped, the psychological effect, who slapped, why slapped, and all the repercussions, that continues to haunt you. Understand? That is why I am saying the matter is different and mind which perceives the matter is different. All suffering is from mind, not from matter. Matter maximum can cause only pain, not suffering. Suffering is from mind. The buddhi, decision maker, always tries to compromise, knowing the mind is delusion. Understand? That is the biggest problem. See, the buddhi knows the ultimate truth, consciousness, but it always consoles itself. I know this is the highest truth, but this is the practical reality now. So let me respond to it. Understand, not responding to what you believe as practical reality is the most practical reality. If you want to be really practical, do not respond to what you believe as practical or what is presented to you as practical. Anybody who does not believe in what is presented to him as practical by the mind becomes winner. The most intelligent game in the life is do not believe what is presented to you as practical by the mind, because mind is waiting to get hurt. And it is loaded with the wounds of the past. It is going to only repeat the pains of the past into the future, or make you believe the pains of the past is going to come into the future, so you can continue to be the slave of the mind. Understand? Mind is like your senior subordinate. He wants to keep you under his control. He can keep only if you are continuously in problem. If you are free from the problem, he cannot keep you under your control, under his control. Understand? When you are declaring your victories, don't look for the people who are celebrating and clapping. Look for the people who are not clapping. They are the cunning enemies. They are your mind waiting to trap you. People who don't celebrate your victory, be careful about them. People who don't celebrate, clap for your victory. Whenever you are successful, don't pay too much attention to people who clap and enjoy your success. They're all your people. They will be with you forever. Be very careful and beware of the people who don't clap and who don't celebrate your success. They are the representatives of your mind who are constantly strategizing to keep you under under their control. Understand? Matter, mind, intelligence, consciousness. The fourth component is pure Paramashiva. Radiating eternally an empowering buddhi, intelligence to act through your mind and the matter. In these four components, you need to understand how the relationship between these four components exists in you. In this horizontal time zone, the relationship is same. If you alter the relationship between these four, if you make your intelligence more powerful than the mind, the equation between these four starts changing. Then you experience something called vertical time zones. Understand? I'm introducing new word. Horizontal time zone, I already explained. All the time zones you have in planet Earth, East Coast time zone or West Coast time zone or Central time zone or Pacific time zone or Indian Standard Time, all these time zones are horizontal time zones. Same sunrises, sets, and different time zones in different places. And the equation between the matter, your mind, and your intelligence and your consciousness is same in all these time zones. If you change the equation, you experience something called vertical time zones. And if you start experiencing vertical time zones, your equations between matter, mind, and intelligence and consciousness will start changing. Then the influence of the consciousness over the intelligence and the influence of the intelligence over the mind and the influence of the mind over the matter will drastically increase. The whole power manifestation science is all about increasing the influence of your consciousness on your intelligence and your intelligence on your mind and on your mind on the matter. Listen. All these four are your components. For example, I'm giving an example. Matter is 25%, mind is 25%, intelligence is 25%, and consciousness is 25% for you in the horizontal time zone. But if you increase the quantity and quality of consciousness percentage in your existence, even if it becomes 30, the whole equation changes. It influences the intelligence. So intelligence also becomes 30. So naturally 30, 30, 60, the mind starts reducing. So intelligence starts penetrating into the mind. not only mind becomes 20%, it loses power over many of the patterns. So, millions of your patterns are destroyed. You start perceiving the matter more clearly, with more truth, with more clarity, more understanding, more real. The delusion drastically comes down. Then you enter into vertical time zone. Understand? The benefit of entering into the vertical time zone, you will realize you don't have death. I tell you. Like when you go to different countries and taste different culture, how you realize many things. Only after coming to West, the first country I traveled outside India is United States of America, USA. Only after coming to USA, I realized there are various brands of cars. I don't want to say India did not have brands of cars, but my awareness was so uninvolved. Did not even look or cognize that there are multiple brands of cars. How, when you move to different cultures and countries, your cognitions mature, you grow. Same way, if you start moving towards the vertical time zone, first thing you will experience is tremendous freedom, liberation. I tell you, a liberated person will be most loving, compassionate, trustworthy. Make friends with him. Because he will never have suffocation inside. He will not do anything wrong to you. He may be raw. Most of the gurus, raw. They are not polished people. Very straight. But they will do so much good to you. I will hate what you need to hate in you. That's all. I will never hate you. I will hate what you need to hate in you to experience liberation and enlightenment. To manifest Paramashiva. I will never hate you. Understand? If you experience vertical time zone, so much of freedom, liberation, you will realize this idea of multiple births and deaths is not idea, that is reality. People ask me, why do Hindus believe in so many gods? I said, no. We don't believe, we just know so many gods exist. People ask me, do you believe in rebirth? I said, hey, I don't believe, I just know that rebirth exists. When you know the realities of multiple gods and goddesses, multiple births and deaths, various states of consciousness, you become so rich. You make very matured decisions in your life. Understand, I tell you. I have seen people who don't have penny but make very mature decisions about life because they have a right knowledge. Same way I have seen billionaires make stupid decisions about life because they do not have right cognitions about life. Knowing multiple births and deaths, knowing the vertical time zone, knowing the truths of multiple gods and goddesses gives you the strength and energy to make mature decisions. For me, he actually exists. In Kailasa, he is there. Right now, he is right now listening that I am declaring to planet Earth that he is there. He is happy and blessing. When you call upon him, I'll give you the password. Om Gam Ganapataye Namaha. Just repeat this and call upon him. He really listens and responds. Especially if you are my disciple, you have a special conclusion inside you. Even when your mind goes through mood swings, ups and downs, you know, Swamiji has said, it means it is true. Let me connect to Ganapati. Because Swamiji said, I know it is truth. That gives you the whole strength, like not only your strength, my strength becomes your strength. That is the power of integrity to Guru. Understand? Whenever you declare your integrity to Guru, all the strength of the Guru becomes your strength. All the powerful cognitions of Guru becomes your powerful cognitions. All the wealth of the Guru becomes your wealth. Declaring integrity to Guru makes you one and equal with Guru. You can confidently walk into Kailasa and say, hey, my guru said Ganapati is here. I came to see him. He gave me the password. Om Gam Ganapataye Namaha. Please inform Ganapati that I have come to see him. Want to have his darshan. My guru told he exists. My guru has seen. I tell you, really he exists. And he responds. Fools are those who say God is one. I tell you, in reality, God is oneness, not one. The oneness is God. I tell you, when you experience the higher consciousness, desired to be integrated to higher consciousness. In my case, I decided I'll be integrated to my Guru, Arunagiri Yogeshwara, that's all. Just my integrity to my Guru, Arunagiri Yogeshwara, he makes sure I am protected. He strategizes properly. The right door will be opened and the right door will be closed. And if all doors are closed, he opens the roof and lifts, airlifts me. He does what needs to be done. He protects. All I know is simple attachment to my Guru and simple obedience. He clearly sends the instruction in the buddhi. Without any doubt, he just clearly speaks. Clearly manifests. I tell you, I entered into Kailasa just with this simple guru pass. MasterCard. My Guru Arunagiri Yogeshwara told me Paramashiva exists. And he has given me this mantra. Please allow me to see Paramashiva. That's all. The doors of Kailasa opened and I saw Paramashiva was there. When I saw, I realized my Guru only is Paramashiva. There is no other surprise. Paramashiva came as Guru and gave me the initiation and password and MasterCard and showed me. That's it. He has to come as a Guru because he need to talk to me in the language I understand and he need to give me the confidence in the form I can connect with. So he assumed the form of my Guru, Arunagiri Yogeshwara, and initiation. That's it. Every day, I'll give you the pure, powerful cognitions from Kailasa, make you understand step by step and make you manifest powers. Today, one powerful cognition, Master is Master Card, Master is Master Key. Simple integrity to Guru words. My Guru has said Ganesha exists. He is alive. He exists. Ganesha is there. He is there. Let me connect with him. Today, let's all connect with Ganesha and ask him to bless us. Make all of us manifest Paramashiva. Remove all the obstacles. And let him bless all of us by removing all the obstacles and make us all experience Paramashiva. Ganapati is such an embodiment of joy. Ganesha is actually a part of our Hindu households. More than God is part of our family. I've seen in my family and all, every marriage, in the marriage ceremony itself, there is a ceremony that Ganesha is born as your son and they will hand over the Ganesha for the married couple, newly married couple to start their Shiva Puja. It's a kind of initiation. In the marriage ceremony itself, there is a ritual where they will tie a sari and sugar cane and put the Ganesha and pour water and show as if Ganesha is like a child urinated and they'll have to change the diaper and they'll say now have Ganesha as your child and start the puja. Ganapati puja will be given. Then they will start Ganapati puja and Shiva Puja and all the pujas. And Ganesha Brahmotsavam is also happening now, auspicious time. So with the blessings of Ganesha, let us start this power manifestation sessions from today. Understand, I'll describe how Ganesha is right now. With 25 heads and 50 hands as the embodiment of Paramashiva in gold and shining way. With 25 elephant heads and 50 hands as embodiment of Paramashiva, Mahaganapati Paramburul is sitting with joy and bliss and blessing all of us in Kailasa, listening to our prayers. Removing all the obstacles, making all of us experience Paramashiva, oneness. Please sit straight. I lead you all connecting to Ganapati. Let's connect with Ganapati and start this sessions on power manifestation, manifesting the state, space, powers, being and super consciousness of Paramashiva. So, sit straight, connect with Ganapati in Kailasa. Om Gam Ganapataye Namaha. Om Gam Ganapataye Namaha. Om Gam Ganapataye Namaha. Sit straight. Close your eyes. Connect with Ganapati, Maha Ganapati, embodiment of Paramashiva, Maha Ganapati Paramburul. Om Gam Ganapataye Namaha. See Maha Ganapati with 25 heads and 50 hands. In shining golden color, with extraordinary joy and blessing all of us.
Ganesha Charanam Param Pavanam Nityanam.
Param Pavanam Nityanandam Gajananam.
स्मरणं परम पावनं नित्यानंदं गजाननं नित्य स्मरणं परम पावनं नित्यानंदं गजाननं.
Let the great presence of Mahaganapati, let the powerful presence of Mahaganapati, let Mahaganapati himself manifest in all of us, bless all of us, remove all the obstacles, make all of us manifest Paramashiva, the state, space, powers, being, super consciousness and oneness of Paramashiva, the pure oneness of Paramashiva. So essence of today's satsang is simple integrity, simple integrity to Guru. Master is the master key. With this, I bless you all. Let's all radiate with integrity, authenticity, responsibility, enriching, causing, living Shuddhatvaita Saivam, Paramashivoham, the eternal bliss, Nityananda. Thank you. Be blissful.
Visualize Swamiji in the third eye. Nityanandam paramasugadam kevalam jnanamurtim dvandvatitam gaganasadattam tattvatyadilakshyam ekam nityam vimalamachalam sarvadi sakshibhutam bhavatitam trigunarahitam sadgurum tam namami. Nityanandam, welcome to Satsang Kailash Kotia at Power Manifestation Session. Welcome all of you. That's beautiful. Today we are going to have simple integrity. Any power, it's going to be simple for us because he himself is going to make it happen for us. Like as though we are making anything happen. At least we want get in between him and the consciousness to manifest through us. The beautiful state that he gives us is three space and powers of Paramashiva, each day through powerful cognition. The powerful cognition is very important because once it becomes your reality and your powerful cognition, it will be permanent in you and raise you to the next conscious level. Swamiji started saying, by more and more we have powerful cognition, you will know why we do what we do. Otherwise, we are unconsciously just happening on planet Earth, but we don't know why we do what we do. More and more the illusion, Maya just withers away. And more we know how the reality is happening around us and how Swamiji is manifesting everything through us. Whether we believe it or not, or whether we understand or not, our breathing goes on and on and on. Same way, the manifestation through us is happening even now. It goes on and on and on. If we give a beautiful, he says, the simple integrity, we will understand the cognition behind all these power manifestations. And it will be as simple as you walking, talking, and you will not even understand that it is supernatural. All that supernatural will become natural for us, Swamiji says. Because we are just in oneness with Swamiji, we understand from where, which context it is happening, how it is happening, why and how we are perceiving it. It's so beautiful. Swamiji said a beautiful thing when he's talking about buddhi. Then he's talking consciousness, buddhi, and it reflects in the mind and matter. He said very beautifully, the buddhi which is happening in the matter and buddhi which is happening in the mind is not the same. Understand how it is different, and we don't have idea about all these things when we are just generally living our life. When we make this cognition as our reality through a power manifestation, when I get a shift with this, I do that as a power manifestation, when the click happens in oneness with Swamiji, simply I will start manifesting more and more powers. Understand that it is only simple integrity, Swamiji said. That is how we just decide that we are going to be in the present moment. The conflict that goes on in us, the past and the present, and the past and the present, that conflict, the inner image and the outer image, we are literally fighting with it and pushing the past into the present. If we just decide, I'm going to be in the present moment, it's just what we cherish, that's it. And we do not hold anything in the inner image and the outer image, except I am Paramashiva. Inside, we are always posting powerless face. Outside, we are always posting a very arrogant and different powerful space, which is not actually powerful, which is also powerless. But instead, we can hold a oneness space with Paramashiva, manifest as the ultimate reality, where he is giving us that oneness as a manifesting power. More and more we manifest powers, we'll start understanding how things work. The more and more the consciousness and buddhi raises, the matter and the mind reduces, influence on us, that's the word he uses, the influence on us reduces. So the more and more the matter and the influence on us, the mind's influence on us, matter, Swamiji says, maximum it will give a pain, that's all, it doesn't do anything. The mind on us, which creates the constant suffering that he explained in the example of how if somebody slaps you, what happened, the carryover of the mind's behavior is actually causes the whole suffering. But it's good that we know it doesn't matter, because that is not us. We know that we can just be without that mind component where we learn to suffer. So the matter, the mind, the buddhi actually gives us the ultimate intelligence, which is a reflection of super consciousness into us as a reality. So when you understand how buddhi is taking us to the next possibility and making us manifest past, we'll be able to understand so beautifully. Now we are going to play the sutra. Once we play the sutra, we'll understand the sutra and then go to the power manifestation. We can just be without that mind component where we learn to suffer. So the matter, the mind, the buddhi actually gives us the ultimate intelligence, which is a reflection of
the Shastra Pramana for the power of body scanning is taken from the Vijnana Bhairavatan. Asti kutrachit आतश्च तन्मयं सर्वं भावयन् भवजिज्जनः चिद्धर्मा सर्वं तन्मयं सर्वं भावयन् भवजिज्जनः
Yes, that's so beautiful. Just a minute. Yes. Here we're going to be doing the body scanning, third eye. And inner vision. Here he says, as per the flow, natural flow of consciousness, chit dharma, in all the bodies, the consciousness is undifferentiated. There exists no differentiation or specificity in nature, quality, or attribute in the consciousness. This is where, if you connect to this, it's a very, very, very powerful sutra. The whole, everything is filled with consciousness. Swamiji so beautifully explains yes. that yeah, inside his body, how he body feels. Scanning, exactly, he feels inner the air outside him. The air outside him, how he feels in the object outside him. The object, how he feels inside it, he goes on expanding that, expanding that, expanding that into everything that you see in your house. Then everything you see in your city, everything you see in your country, like that you expand into the whole space of consciousness, the universe and the galaxy itself. You understand you are living in the every cell of consciousness, outside and inside. Whatever you're seeing, you're perceiving, everything is consciousness. The ultimate oneness with Paramashiva, that you know everything that exists is consciousness. And how you perceive it, your reality is. So here he says, you don't have to have, it's not, there is nothing undifferentiable. It is not anything different for attribute, for quality, for nature. Everywhere that is flooded, we are literally made of consciousness and all of us and everything that exists is one and the same. If you call it an atom, everything is made of atom, and that is same in everybody. Even if you take as a physics, it's same in everybody. So the consciousness which is there is same in everybody, everything, everywhere. That's why I am Paramashiva is infinite possibility, infinite occurrence, and infinite intelligence, infinite power, Swamiji says. Why? Is because he says everything is made of that subtle thing, consciousness. Yes, in this way, when one places his awareness and is absorbed in the consciousness, exists in all being, he wins the dualistic worldly existence. First, he wins the dualistic and realizes the non-dualistic oneness in all the being. First, when he understands the consciousness and he becomes aware and is absorbed in consciousness existing in all being, initially he wins the dualistic worldly existence and realizes the non-dual oneness in all being. So here Swamiji very clearly explains the whole thing, how the chit dharma, the consciousness, continuously happening in all of us, in everything, in everywhere, everyone, is simple integrity to Swamiji. We will manifest this power because he is the master key for us. The simple integrity happens when you understand and have deeper understanding what it is. And then the integrity is not some rule. It is the way it exists. Like, for example, we are integrated to the way we exist. The same thing. That is the way it exists. So the consciousness is in everything, in all bodies, and the consciousness is undifferentiated. There exists no differentiation in specificity, in nature, quality, or attribute, in the consciousness. Completely we become one and the same. If you understand the conflict outside and inside, the inner image, outer image, if you break and fall into the present moment oneness with Swamiji, the restful awareness that everything is one and the same. Holding on the space with Swamiji in such an enlightenment space, you will be able to manifest all the powers of Paramashiva, because you understand that everything is nothing but your reflection, and you can just pick up any file and give it to anybody, because you know everything is part of you, physically you. So you understand how your body functions, you understand
नित्यानंद परम शिवोऽहम् ॐ नित्यानंद परम शिवोऽहम् ॐ नित्यानंद परम शिवोऽहम्
ओम नित्यानंद परम शिवोहम 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 शिवो
Yes, thank you. Please, now verify, take a couple of minutes and verify. And if you'd like to share, you can unmute and share or post it in the Kala Zoom chat. Yes, please share it as everyone so that everybody can see it. You can post it in the Kailash courtyard also. We'll post the link for you. You can verify and post the results in Kailash courtyard manifesting power page. Any Shakti you should surrender when Swamiji shows us to Swamiji's lotus feet. The more you surrender, the more Buddhi starts happening in us. The Shakti becomes the Buddhi. The Buddhi is the intelligence. And more intelligence happen in our system, more and more power manifestation starts. So please post everything in Kailash Kotiyan Manifesting Power page. Now let's sit straight and end with the Purna Mantra. Visualize Swamiji in the third eye.
She's so cute. I really love to watch her sessions. Purna Mada Purna Mada Purna Purna Mada Purna Purnasya Purnamataya Purnameva Vishishte Om Shanti 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 Hari Om Tat Sat Sarvam Bhagavate Sri Nityananda Paramashivam Padaka Arpanamastu Om Nitya.
Thank you Nityananda, see you all tomorrow in the next session. Bye bye.
शिवोऽहम् ॐ नित्यानन्द परमशिवोऽहम् ॐ नित्यानन्द परमशिवोऽहम् ॐ नित्यानन्द परमशिवोऽहम्
Shiva.
शिवोऽहम् ॐ नित्यानन्द परमशिवोऽहम् ॐ नित्यानन्द परमशिवोऽहम् ॐ नित्यानन्द परमशिवोऽहम्
ஓம் அனந்தாய நமஹ. ஓம் அனந்த புண்ணிய பலதாய நமஹ. ஓம் அகிலாண்ட கோட்டி பிரம்மாண்ட நாயகாய நமஹ. ஓம் அகிலாண்ட கோட்டி பிரம்மாண்ட ரூபினே நமஹ. ஓம் அகிலாண்ட கோட்டி பிரம்மாண்ட ஜனகாய நமஹ. ஓம் அஜயாய நமஹ. ஓம் அஜாய நமஹ. ஓம் அணிமாதி அஷ்டசித்தி பிரதாயகாய நமஹ. ஓம் ஆசுதோஷாய நமஹ. ஓம் அவ்யயாய நமஹ. ஓம் அர்த்தநாரீஸ்வராய நமஹ. ஓம் அவஸ்தாத்ரே விநிர்முக்தாய நமஹ. ஓம் அவ்யாஜ கருணாமூர்த்தயே நமஹ. ஓம் அநாதநாதாய நமஹ. ஓம் ஆனந்தகந்த நிலையாய நமஹ. ஓம் ஆர்த்தத்ராணபராயணாய நமஹ. ஓம் ஈப்சித பலதாயகாய நமஹ. ஓம் உஷ்ணீஷ்ணதராய நமஹ. ஓம் உற்சவ பிரியாய நமஹ. ஓம் கலி கல்மஷஹாரினே நமஹ. ஓம் கர்ம பலதாயகாய நமஹ. ஓம் காரிய காரண விநிர்முக்தாய நமஹ. ஓம் கைவல்ய பததாயகாய நமஹ. ஓம் கிருபாகராய நமஹ. ஓம் த்ரயஸ்த்ரிம்சத் கோதி தேவதா சேவியமான பாதாப்ஜாய நமஹ. ஓம் சர்வகாமதம்சினே நமஹ. ஓம் கல்பதரு மூலவாசினே நமஹ. ஓம் கல்பதரவே நமஹ. ஓம் நிஷ்கலாய நமஹ. ஓம் நாமரூப விவர்ஜிதாய நமஹ. ஓம் பக்தவத்சலாய நமஹ. ஓம் சர்வவியாதி பிரசமனாய நமஹ. ஓம் சர்வ ஆதி நிவாரணாய நமஹ. ஓம் பாபாக்ஞாய நமஹ. ஓம் சகசிரார ஆரூடாய நமஹ. ஓம் பக்த ஹ்ரித் பத்ம சுஸ்திதாய நமஹ. ஓம் சச்சிதானந்தாய நமஹ. ஓம் வேத வேதாந்த வேத்யாய நமஹ. ஓம் பரமாத்மனே நமஹ. ஓம் சர்வசாட்சினே நமஹ. ஓம் யோகநாதாய நமஹ. ஓம் தத்வஜானப்பிரதாய நமஹ. ஓம் மாய பாஷ விவர்ஜிதாய நமஹ. ஓம் பசுபதயே நமஹ. ஓம் கருணாசாகராய நமஹ. ஓம் பிரேமஸ்வரூபினே நமஹ. ஓம் காலாதீதாய நமஹ. ஓம் பாக்யவிருத்தி பரிவர்த்தகாய நமஹ. ஓம் சர்வஸ்வதந்திரியாய நமஹ. ஓம் நிஜஸ்வாதந்திரியதாயகாய நமஹ. ஓம் நிர்விகல்பாய நமஹ. ஓம் சரணாகதவத்சலாய நமஹ. ஓம் பிடதி புரீஷாய நமஹ. ஓம் சாந்தாய நமஹ. ஓம் சமஸ்த கல்யாண குணான்விதாய நமஹ. ஓம் பரஞ்சோதிஷே நமஹ. ஓம் சோமசூரிய அக்னிநயனாய நமஹ. ஓம் பாவகம்யாய நமஹ. ஓம் சர்வாந்தர்யாமினே நமஹ. ஓம் ஜகத்வியாபினே நமஹ. ஓம் பவபந்தனகாந்தனாய நமஹ. ஓம் பவசக்கர பரிவர்த்தகாய நமஹ. ஓம் தட்சிணாமூர்த்தி ஸ்வரூபாய நமஹ. ஓம் பதித பாவனாய நமஹ. ஓம் பகவதே நமஹ. ஓம் ஜெகநாதாய நமஹ. ஓம் சகல ஐஸ்வர்ய பிரதாய நமஹ. ஓம் சுவாமினே நமஹ. ஓம் ரக்ஷாகராய நமஹ. ஓம் நித்யாய நமஹ. ஓம் ஹிரண்யகர்பாய நமஹ. ஓம் விஸ்வயோனயே நமஹ. ஓம் பஸ்மப்ரியாய நமஹ. ஓம் பஸ்ம திரிபுந்திர விலிப்தலலாட்டாய நமஹ. ஓம் சித்த விருந்தவந்திதாய நமஹ. ஓம் சகலாகம சம்வேத்யாய நமஹ. ஓம் ருத்ராட்ச பிரியாய நமஹ. ஓம் ருத்ராட்ச ஆபரணாய நமஹ. ஓம் பக்திவஷ்யாய நமஹ. ஓம் நிராதாராய நமஹ. ஓம் நிராகாராய நமஹ. ஓம் குணாதீதாய நமஹ. ஓம் புராண புருஷோத்தமாய நமஹ. ஓம் சித்த விருத்தி நிரோதகாய நமஹ. ஓம் தியானகம்யாய நமஹ. ஓம் தர்ம ஆதர்ம விவர்ஜிதாய நமஹ. ஓம் நித்யதிருப்தாய நமஹ. ஓம் நிரஹங்காராய நமஹ. ஓம் மிருத்யுஞ்சயாய நமஹ. ஓம் சர்வோபாதி விநிர்முக்தாய நமஹ. ஓம் நிர்குணாய நமஹ. ஓம் குணமயாய நமஹ. ஓம் மரணோர்மி நாசனாய நமஹ. ஓம் சமதர்ஷினே நமஹ. ஓம் அர்த்திய அமிர்தாய நமஹ. ஓம் தீனபந்தவே நமஹ. ஓம் மாத்ருபூதேஸ்வராய நமஹ. ஓம் மதுராதிக திதிக்ஷாவதே நமஹ. ஓம் சம்பிரதாய பிரவர்த்தகாய நமஹ. ஓம் சர்வ மந்த்ரார்த்தாய நமஹ. ஓம் சௌலபிய பரிபூர்ணாய நமஹ. ஓம் சமாதிஸ்திதாய நமஹ. ஓம் வரதாய நமஹ. ஓம் சர்வசாஸ்திரார்த்தாய நமஹ. ஓம் பஞ்சகிருத்திய பராயணாய நமஹ. ஓம் திவ்ய தேஹாய நமஹ. ஓம் ஆதுலித சக்திமதே நமஹ. ஓம் பவரோக பேசஜாய நமஹ. அத தூபஹ. ओम दूर्वसी दूर दूर्वन्तं दूर्वतं योऽस्मान् दूर्वतितं दूर्वयं वयं दूर्वामस्त्वं देवानामसि सस्नितमं पव्रतमं जुस्ततमं अग्नितमं देवहुतम् अमृतस्य रवृद्धानं मृगमस्व मात्वा मित्रस्व चक्षुषा प्रेक्षेमभिर्म संविक्ता मात्वा हिगुंसिषुम् ओम सर्वदेवदेवी स्वरूपाय भगवते श्री नित्यानंद परमशिवाय नमः दुबं आग्रापयामि। दीपः ओम उद्दीप्यस्य जातवेदो प्रज्ञनिरतं मम पशोगुस्य महिमा वह जीवनं च दिशो दिश मानो हिगुंसि जातवेदो गामस्वं पुरुषं जगत् अभिप्रतिज्ञागहि श्रियाम परिपातय। ओम श्री नित्यानंदेश्वरी पराशक्ति समेत श्री नित्यानंदेश्वर परमशिवाय नमः दीपं दर्शयामि। नैवेद्यम् ओम मधुवाताय ते मधुक्षरंदी सिंधव माध्वीर्नसंदोसती मधुनक्त मुतोषसि मधुमत्पार्थ्विकं रजः मधुद्यो रसन पिता मधुमानो वनस्पतिर्मधुवागमस्त सूर्यः माध्वीर्गावो भवन्तुनः मधु मधु मधु। ओम श्री नित्यानंदेश्वरी पराशक्ति समेत श्री नित्यानंदेश्वर परमशिवाय नमः नैवेद्यं निवेदयामि। नैवेद्यानन्तरम् आचमनीयं समर्पयामि। कर्पूरनीराजनम् ओम राजाधिराजाय प्रसज्ञ साहिने नमो वयं वै श्रवणाय कुर्महे समे कामान् कामकामाय मह्यं कामेश्वरो वै श्रवणो ततादु कुबेराय वै श्रवणाय महाराजाय नमः। कर्पूरगौरं करुणावतारं संसारसारं भुजगेन्द्रहारं सदा वसन्तं हृदयारविन्दे भवं भवानी सहितं नमामि भवं भवानी सहितं नमामि भवं भवानी सहितं नमामि। श्री नित्यानंदेश सर्वदेव देवी स्वरूपाय भगवते श्री नित्यानंद परमशिवाय नमः कर्पूर नीराजनम संदर्शयामि।
शिवोऽहम् ॐ नित्या
शिवोऽहम् ॐ नित्यानन्द परमशिवोऽहम् ॐ नित्यानन्द परमशिवोऽहम् ॐ नित्यानन्द परमशिवोऽहम्
निधनपदये नमः ॐ निधनपदान्तिकाय नमः ॐ ऊर्ध्वाय नमः ॐ ऊर्ध्वलिङ्गाय नमः ॐ हिरण्याय नमः ॐ हिरण्यलिङ्गाय नमः ॐ सुवर्णाय नमः ॐ सुवर्णलिङ्गाय नमः ॐ दिव्याय नमः ॐ दिव्यलिङ्गाय नमः ॐ भवाय नमः ॐ भवलिङ्गाय नमः ॐ सर्वाय नमः ॐ सर्वलिङ्गाय नमः ॐ शिवाय नमः ॐ शिवलिङ्गाय नमः ॐ ज्वलाय नमः ॐ ज्वललिङ्गाय नमः ॐ आत्माय नमः ॐ आत्मलिङ्गाय नमः ॐ परमाय नमः ॐ परमलिङ्गाय नमः ॐ एतत् सोमस्य सूर्यस्य सर्वलिङ्गग्रस्थापयति पाणि मन्त्रं पवित्रं सद्यो जातं प्रपद्यामि सद्यो जाताय वै नमो नमः भवे भवे नाति भवे भवस्व मां भवोद्भवाय नमः वामदेवाय नमो ज्येष्ठाय नमः श्रेष्ठाय नमो रुद्राय नमः कालाय नमः कलविकरणाय नमो फलविकरणाय नमो भलाय नमो फलप्रमथनाय नमः सर्वभूतदमनाय नमो मनोन्मनाय नमः अघोरेभ्यो दघोरेभ्यो घोरघोरधरेभ्यः सर्वेभ्यः सर्वसर्वेभ्यो नमस्ते अस्तु रुद्ररूपेभ्यः तत्पुरुषाय विद्महे महादेवाय धीमहि तन्नो रुद्रप्रचोदयात् ईशानस्सर्वविद्यानाम् ईश्वरस्सर्वभूतानां ब्रह्माधिपतिर्ब्रह्मणोऽधिपतिर्ब्रह्म शिवो मे अस्तु सदा शिवो ॐ व्योमव्यापिने व्योमरूपाय सर्वव्यापिने शिवाय अनन्थाय अनाथाय अनाश्रिताय ध्रुवाय शाश्वताय योगपीठ संस्थिताय नित्य योगिने ओम। न तत्र सूर्यो भान्ति न चन्द्रतारकं नेमा विद्युतो भान्ति कुठोऽयमग्निः तमेव भान्तमनुभाति सर्वं दस्य भाषा सर्वमिदं विभाति। नित्यानन्द परमशिवोऽहम् ॐ नित्या शिवोऽहम् ॐ नित्यानन्द परमशिवोऽहम् ॐ नित्यानन्द परमशिवोऽहम् ॐ नित्यानन्द परमशिवोऽहम् शिवोऽहम् ॐ नित्यानन्द परमशिवोऽहम् ॐ नित्यानन्द परमशिवोऽहम् ॐ नित्यानन्द परमशिवोऽहम् शिवोऽहम् ॐ।
श्यामप्रिया
माँ
श्यामप्रिया माँ
माइक की जरूरत है।